What's going on, guys? This is Rabbit for you. We're playing The Forest today, and I'm going to be doing a quick tutorial on the very basics of how to get started. And that'll be involving how to make a bow, axe, some arrows for the bow, obviously. A campfire, everyone needs a campfire. And some defense, and some extras, basically the simplest controls. Nothing really too complex. If you can't learn it, don't play. Only kidding. Great game. And there goes Timmy's head off the table. Poor Timmy. He gets it every time. For the purposes of this tutorial, I do have the game on peaceful, but as you can see, the dude in front of it, that is called a mutant. He's one of the enemies in the game. As a matter of fact, I don't actually think there's any other kind of enemies except from mutants. Right, so as soon as you spawn in, you basically want to grab everything off the plane, everything you can. Take it all. If you just look at an object, it'll slowly but surely highlight it. As in, if I can find another thing, there we go. If I look away from it, it doesn't highlight. For this one, you want to press and hold E, and it'll eat. Some other objects in the game you do need to press and hold, like for example there's a log sled which helps you transport the logs, and for that to control that you actually want to press and hold A to take control. But anyway, back to the video. If we just hop out this plane, crack open some suitcases, it's not as if anyone's going to need them anymore. Grab a couple of stones, a couple of sticks. They'll always come in handy. A couple of leaves. They'll come in handy later. Right, I've got maximum. Ooh, there's deers. Right. Ooh! Want to kill a spider if I can. There we go. I want to catch them fellas. I'm going to need them feathers. Did I get them? To open the crafting mat, you want to press I. Yay, I got them. Right. And to sprint and things, you basically hold your left shift and you'll start sprinting. Space bar to jump, and basically your normal PC controls to move forwards and whatnot. W forward, S back, A left, D right. Pretty straightforward PC controls, standard controls basically, your mouse to look around. Right, so the first thing that we're going to make, what I didn't actually mention at the start, is a spear. A spear is very useful, and it's very simple. Bring up the crafting mat, two sticks, right click on this gear icon, there's your weak spear. With this spear, you can either stab the enemy, or if you've got a good aim and you can work it out, you can throw it. Okay, here, wash this blood off. Didn't wash off for some reason. Right. Get it off now. There we go. Right, so I'm going to need to build a campfire. So to do this, I'm going to bring up the journal book. It's a simple key, you just press B. Yeah, it's your survival book. It's got everything in here, like your blueprints and things that you'll need to build your own base, your own defences, traps, furniture, storage, everything, basically. Everything that you can build in the game is in this book. If it's not in the book, you can't build it. So, first things, we want a fire. Now, as you can see, we get 4 different types of fires. My personal favourite would probably be the bonfire. But we're not going to need a bonfire just for this video. Something short and simple, basic fire. Once you click on it, you'll see this little thing show up. Little icon of a blueprint. So we'll find somewhere we want. This'll do. If we press and hold R, it rotates that item. So we'll find to the way we want it. And then we'll press E. And it's placed. If you're not happy with where it is, you can press and hold C, which will delete the item. But we're quite happy with that. Press E. And we'll build a fire. You do require the stuffs for that. I needed sticks and leaves, but it tells you in the book anyway. For example, we needed 7 leaves and 2 sticks. Pretty straightforward and simple. Press and hold E. Wait, I didn't want to work. There we go. And we have a fire. So that's pretty straightforward on how to make a fire. Next we'll want to make some arrows, now that we've actually got Whisper, so we can go and chase down some birdies. Grab a couple more sticks. Find the birds. If we press control, we can crouch. For some new players, the control key you'll have to press and hold, but you can go into your settings and change that. No. Wait, I got that one. But I need more. We're going to need a total of 5 feathers to make some arrows. Come on, little birdie, land. Nope, you're not going to land. Where did it go? I'll get another bird in a second. But another thing we can do if we're needing food is find a pond, like so. See if there's any fish in there. Doesn't look like there's any fish. Oh, there they are. Just get in nice and close and pie eat it. And we'll go, we've got a fish. This thing here means there is a mutant's camp nearby. So we will want to be finding that shortly. First of all, I want to catch a bird. I was just about to say I've lost the plane, but I haven't. Right. Bird, bird, bird. Bird, 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 bird. Oops. If you ever do get caught by the fire, by being silly like that, just either run to the pond or wait until it burns out. But running the pond's basically common sense, it'll put it out. Very realistic that way. Normally I don't have a problem finding some animals. Oh, found some food. There is some plants in game you can eat, but then there is some that you can't. There we go. Just got a deer. Let's chop up this deer. birds landing around here, but I can't find any of them. Birds. As soon as I see one land, I'm gonna pounce. We'll go down this way. We might be able to catch some of the mutant camp or something. If we can find some rope while we're here, because we're gonna need some rope. Excuse me, guys. My cough hasn't cleared up since I caught the bug. Nope, no rope. I seen a bird land. Let's go get it. What it says to fly away. I need the spear. Where did it go? There it is. No, these plants are good for hydration and a little bit of food. Wouldn't rely on your plants too much, guys, because it will eventually screw you over. So you want to basically start making food as soon as you can. But the plants are enough to keep you going until you start hunting down your deers and getting your meat, your fish. How many feathers have I got now? I've got two. I need three more feathers. Come on. We can do this. If I just run through the forest, randomly press an E, it'll pick up things I can use until I'm full. I found a little survivor's camp. These are normally good for other bits and bobs as well. So hopefully we can find what we're looking for here. And the game's gotta be a twat and not give us what we are wanting. Head back. If you've noticed on the bottom right side of your screen, this is your main HUD. You've got your health, the red bar, you've got your thirst and your hunger in the centre, and then you've got your stamina on the right, which is represented by the blue bars. Very handy to keep an eye on them. Trying to get a squirrel. Nope, it's off. Come on, we need these birds. Do 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 do. There we go. Catch the fellers. No way. Oh. There we go, guys. Right. Woo! We did it! Right, so to make the arrows, we're going to make 5 per set. So there's 1 stick and 5 feathers. Done. Pardon me. We've got 5 arrows. But of course, they're no good without the bow. Now, this is where the adventure comes in. Now, we're going to need some rope. And if I'm not mistaken, you can combine cloth to make rope, but I don't have enough. So if we get our axe, and we go and collect some more things from the suitcases, we might be able to find enough cloth to make some rope. Alright, let's count this, guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 bits of cloth make a rope. Right, and now to make the bow. We want 1 stick, 1 cloth, and 1 rope. We've now got our bow. So we can now hunt animals a little easier. So now that we've got the bow made, we've got arrows made, we've got fire, some basic controls, we're pretty much good to go. The longest part was getting the feathers to make the arrows, but it's not normally so painstakingly long to get the feathers. It's normally straightforward, let's do this basically. Right, and now I need another rope, so I'm going to break open some more of these suitcases, and once we've got the suitcases broke open, so yeah, we've got the bow, arrows, we've got fire, some basic controls. I want to find this plane again. Where's this plane? I need the plane. As you guys can tell, around the edges of the screen, it's like going frosty and icy because my dude's cold. So I need to find the plane. Where did I build my fire? Where did I build the fire? Built in here, didn't I? Let's get a bit of light. Press L. There we go. It's right in front of us. Get a fire going. If we press R near the fire when we've got some food, and then press C, we can hide the food on there and cook it. Alright, so let's have a look, guys. Let's do a quick catch up on what we've got, what we've done, what we still need to do. So we have the bow and arrows. We need to make an axe. Although we've got an axe, we can make another axe. Sometimes it's useful, it all depends. So bow, arrows, fire, basic controls. Now I'm going to show you how to make an axe. We'll want some more rope. Right, so now we want a stick, some rope, and a stone. Really straightforward. Done. We've now got a crafted axe. So the only thing left basically is how to build your little camp. And to do that, all we do is press B, shelters. Now you get a temporary shelter, I think it's only like a one time use, could be wrong, I think it is. Or we get hunting shelters, log cabins or small cabin. You can make custom buildings, as in if I go to here, we've got custom foundation, floors, roof, walls, stuff like that. So, but for the purpose of this video, we're going to just make a hunting shelter next to the fire. So we'll turn that around, make it look pretty, and we'll straight away add everything we've got. We need two more rocks. Done. Seven logs, real simple, just chop down a tree. Place them on. There's 4 out of 7. One more tree should do it. I think on average between the trees you get 4 to 5 logs per tree. That's randomly went everywhere. Relight the fire. Right, and there's our basic little shelter things. We can sleep the night or we can save it, but for the purposes of this video I'm not saving it because I've already got saving things and got things built. So we'll just skip the night over. And it's morning. Food cooked yet? Yep. Don't worry guys, it doesn't actually take overnight to cook food. There is a way of getting clean water to drink instead of polluted water, which is your lakes. Rainwater, that's clean. And obviously ponds basically are polluted, but for some reason can't get a drink of any. Never mind, don't quite need it yet anyway. Right, see, on a pre-haps you get lost. Really easy to find your way back to camp. All you do is you look around and there's a big home icon. Pretty goddamn simple. So we'll get back to camp. So the basics of our camp is we've got a fire, a shelter, we need some sort of bits and bobs basically. I'm not really going to show you how to make all of this. It's really simple guys. I've showed you how to make a fire and a shelter. It's same principle. Click the stuff, place it, job done. Your log sled, 21 sticks, is the best thing to use to carry your logs. It can carry up to 11 logs at a time. And your dude can carry 2 logs per time. You can carry 10 sticks, 10 stones, at once, which is quite handy. Let's go around collecting some sticks to build this. Nie was jedno. No. We can change the colour of the flag so we can see it in the distance. So we're all the way over here. You can run with this as well, by the way, guys, so don't think you just have to walk with that. Chop down this tree. Get down. Right. So we'll run up and collect these. We'll go to this and press C. It'll place them in. Let's just double check over this way to make sure I didn't drop a fifth. Because all logs are very handy, especially when you start building a big base on my co-op save. I've started building a big base and it was like the wall itself, it's still not even finished, and it was like 296 logs and it's still unfinished because the place I've built the base, it's not very resourceful for the trees and the where the trees are. Sometimes the trees decide to fall and destroy some of the walls, so I need to keep rebuilding it, which annoying. I am working on a theory of what way you cut the tree for the what way it falls, so let's test that out right now actually. Collect these ones. Right, so we'll just take us back to camp. Done. Right, we'll test it on these trees. We'll do two trees per test. So if I stand this side and chop the tree, it should fall that way. You've got to fall forward. Yep. So that means if we do it that way, it's got to fall that way. Yeah, you guys can tell it pretty much looks straightforward. Whatever way you're facing, that's the way it's going to decide to go. Let's get all these logs up next to each other. I'm like, do they actually have, need to build another fire. Keep doing that, press the wrong button. Fire, we'll have a basic fire. Right. We'll give that a light. And if I equip this, I'm going to fill it at a pond if I can. You can boil water, which cleans it as well, so. But for some weird reason, it's not letting us fill us up. Oh, the crater there. Don't actually know what the crater has anything to do. I'm positive something to do with a story behind the game, behind little Timmy. Could be wrong, but that's my guess. And for some reason it's not letting us fill up at that pond. So we'll go and find another one. As you can tell, polluted water. Get back to camp. Should be able to put it on the fire and boil it, which also cleans water, so you don't need to wait for it to rain to collect the water and things like that. Right. Move that log out of the way. There we go. Right, just to get rid of these logs, I'm going to show you the basics of building a wall. It's pretty much similar. We'll do a custom wall. Left click there is a starting point. You drag it out to where you want it. Say you want it about there. Left click again to about there. Left click again. To about there, left click again, to about there, left click again, bring it over about there, and then to the rock. Right, instead of, like, to finish off the blueprint building, instead of pressing left click, you just press E wherever you want it to stop, and it builds it to there. So that's going to cost 50 logs, so we'll just straightforward. There's one wall. Two walls. Pretty straightforward. If you go to a wall and press R, it gives you different options. One with a window, so you can see in and out. That's what a window's for. One with a door, with the lock on this side. One with a lock on this side, or straight wall. So we'll just go and collect these logs, finish this. I believe water is finished as well, on the boil. Right, I think that was all the trees we cut down. A finished wall, obviously you can't run through it, but a blueprinted wall that's still in the processes of getting built, you can still travel through it. Doesn't matter how high it is, you can slug it through. Right, yep. There we go, we've drunk that and we are fine. Yeah, you run away, dear. Give us a little bit of a clear. Don't know if you can do it with the grass. Nope, you can't do it with the grass. Right, so, yeah, that's basically how we get that done. We do have, done again, we do have some defense buildings, like defense spikes, a wall reinforcement, a catapult. I might actually build a catapult. I've never used one of them. Yep, okay. We're building a catapult, just for the purposes of this video as well. We'll swing this around. Yeah, we'll pretend we're attacking our own base. Don't even know the range on this thing, don't know how it works or anything, so... this is gonna be fun to find out. Do we need rocks? No, we don't need rocks. We do need sticks. I believe the thin trees like this give you sticks. So we'll find that out. I'm not sure about that. I need a bit of rope. I'm going to need to go through these suitcases and get some more cloth. You can find rope at camps and things, in tunnels and stuff, so you don't need to worry about just keeping doing that. Right, so let's back up here. Right now I need 5 logs. If you notice on the bottom left it says Galil logs 0 out of 33, it'll always stay at 0 unless you're carrying a log. Whatever you're carrying, that's when it'll say how many you've got, but you can only carry 2 at a time. Sled, you can carry up to 11, but it doesn't count 11 for some reason. Instead of it giving you 2 Galil logs for different projects, it will just add it on the total. Squirrel. Squirrel head, anyone? And that's what happens when you try and pick up 3. Log up again. No. So what can we put in this catapult, a fire catapult? So I can see that white marker, that's what we're aiming, where we're going to hit. So we'll see there. But I need to find out what we can put in it. We've got stones, got sticks and things, so why can't we load it? Take stones to hand or something? Ah, right. There we go. So, now if we... So we need to have stones in hand. And we'll place them on there. And then... like that. Right, let's destroy everything at base. Let's see about there. Didn't destroy anything, but it works. Right guys, I believe I've covered everything on what I'm actually needing to cover. I've showed you how to get the crafting mat up and how to use that. We've made a bow that we still have actually, with all arrows, surprisingly. Showed you how to make a stone axe, showed you how to build a fire, build basic things. There is other things you can make, but that would just take far too long to do things all in one video anyway. If you guys are wanting another video made on how to do something, like, I don't know, a sea house, let us know down in the comments, drop a like, hit the subscribe button, help the channel out a lot, and let us know what you guys think, and I'll make another video if you're needing something explained in more detail. I'll go into more detail on how to do things, and how to get things up and running. But yeah, I think I've covered the basics. You've made a bow, you've made an axe, you've made arrows, you've made a fire, you've made some defense. You know the basic controls. You bring, press I, it brings up the crafting mat. You press B, it brings up the survival book. You press left control, you can crouch. Basic PC gaming controls, you know all that. So yeah, don't really think there's anything else I need to cover. So yeah, smash that like button, hit the subscribe button while you're down there, and I'll see you guys in the next video.